Jordin, coming off last year, freshman of the year in the Pac-12, NIT champion, and how many points did you have in the championship game?
31.
To be able to take control of a game and to step up in ways that other people wouldn't have the confidence to do, have you always had that innately?
Yeah, but I think that's just what comes with experience. I've been in a lot of tough situations like that in high school, playing high school games, state games. So being in that situation in the college level is exciting because, you know, you've been through that already. So when it comes for me, like, that's just another game for me. So I didn't really feel pressure. I enjoyed it. So
that's great. Yeah. Describe the experience of playing in South Korea and taking over the leadership role with older players.
South Korea was a great experience. I just love being there, meeting new people, seeing other people from different countries and their culture. I can remember like a specific time, like during the opening ceremonies, like different countries had their own little dances and music, and it was just really cool to see that and have other countries combine with other countries and just do their own thing. That was really cool. And then stepping into the role as a leader, being the youngest on the team, I mean, that's what the players expected me to do. That was my job, being a point guard, especially the leader, the main point guard of the team. And Tanya, the assistant coach, she was just on me a lot. Practice, games, just making sure we stay under control and making sure it was my job to know what was going on in the game and making sure we stay calm. And so she really pushed me and helped me through that.
How do you think you have found your voice over the last year?
I think in practice, knowing what to expect now as a sophomore, just being through that whole process as a freshman and knowing what it's like, and now coming into a new year, I know what to expect, I know my mindset, and just being more aggressive with my team. I think that I found my voice. And also playing with the USA team this past summer and being one of the youngest players on the team and being the leader of that team, that kind of like carried over into this summer. So I think that's where it all started.
You have something really special going on right now with your internship. Tell me about that.
Yes, I work for a music company called Liner Up, or Blue Elon Records. And pretty much what I do is I market some of the artists that they have. They have about 12 artists. And I pretty much just market their like social media. I help them find things that they're interested in. And I just, from my perspective as a young woman, like, what would interest me in hearing their music, and people my age, like what would they like to hear and stuff they would like to see on their social media. So that's pretty much what I do. It's pretty cool.
That is cool.
Yeah.
What other things do you want to do within the music industry?
Well, I want to learn how to write music. I don't know. I want to sing, but I don't know if that's something that I really want to do. I just like to sing whenever, but something that I really like to do is write music. Yeah.
So you like to sing whenever?
I mean,
you open that door, I'm walking through. I'm walking through.
We were going to get there eventually, so I had to just throw it out there.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment, Jordin Canada.
I am in love with you. You set me free. I can't do this thing called life without you here with me, cause I'm dangerously in love with you, and I'll never leave. Just keep loving me the way I love you loving me.
Thank you, Jordin.
You're welcome.
That was Spotlight with Jordin Canada.